Then we'll discuss about laws of refraction. There are two laws of refraction. Okay, that is first law is law one, that the angle of the incident ray, the normal and the refracted ray, they will all lie in the same plane. One plane, and on the opposite side of the normal, this is the normal, this is the interface, this is how the ray strikes the surface at this point and towards the normal bends like that. This is I, this is R, this angle is called angle of refraction, I is called angle of incidence. This line and this line, they lie in the same plane, that means in the plane of the paper. This is the surface, the ray strikes here, incident ray. This is the normal, okay, and suppose this is the refracted ray. So I will better draw here, it will better, it is like that, okay. This is the case, they all lie in the same plane, in one plane they lie. The ray R can be in this direction also, you can make R in this direction also, you can make this angle R. But which R you are going to take? The R is lying in the same plane. So they all lie in the same plane. You cannot say that the ray is making an angle of R and lie that. This is not in one plane. These are in different planes. This is one plane, this is another plane. You can see this is one plane, this is another plane. So one plane means they lie in the same plane, all the lines lie in the same plane, just like the plane of paper. Law number two. So the first law talks about how the lines lie, in what planes they lie, in which side of the normal they lie. Basically, we are interested in the incident ray and the refracted ray. Incident ray is this one and the refracted ray is this one. After refraction, the ray is called refracted ray. Before refraction, the ray is called incident ray. What happens to that ray? So before and after, which side of the normal they are lying? This is a normal, the incident ray is lying in this side, left side of this normal, and the right side is the refracted ray. Whether this refracted ray is towards the normal or away from the normal, but it is lying on the other side of the normal. So the first law talks about these three. With respect to the normal, the incident ray lie and the refracted ray lie on the opposite sides. They don't lie in the same line. There is a case possible, in case of that we will discuss in JEE video lectures, that there is also a possibility, though we should not discuss over here, but still, there is also a possibility that they lie in the same side of the normal. That means, if this is a normal, then the incident ray, the refracted ray will not be on this side, will be on this side. This is possible. This is also refraction, but this happens in case of meta material. In case of meta material, this is possible. but that we are not going to discuss here. Only this we are talking about, that the rays will lie on the opposite sides of the normal. This way, not in the same side, opposite side. This is also possible. There is metamaterials there. So in this case, the refractive index is negative. Negative here, and the refractive index mu is positive in this case. This is not what we are going to discuss. This is beyond the scope of the syllabus. Only we know that this mu is called refractive index, that we are going to learn the law number 2. The second law talks about the Snell's law. It is basically Snell's law, that the ratio of the sine of the angle of incidence to the sine of the angle of refraction is a constant for any two pair of media. So this is second law. That is, it says that this is called angle of incidence, this is called angle of refraction. The second law states that the sine of the angle of incidence to the sine of the angle of refraction is a constant. This constant, latter, will call it as refractive index of the pair of the media, that we will discuss later. Okay, thank you.